speaking to us here at Money 2020.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. How are you guys disrupting the mortgage space?
I think we're radically transforming both mortgages and home ownership. Mm-hmm. We're making home ownership more affordable and accessible by digitizing the mortgage process, by taking decisions that used to take 3 weeks to 3 months and giving them to consumers in 3 seconds to 3 minutes. And in doing that, and using technology to automate chunks of the process, what we are able to do is pass on those savings to consumers and basically enable them to afford their dream home sooner than they would traditionally.
So innovation obviously is key to staying ahead mm-hmm. of the game. What are you doing in the mortgage space in that sense?
So the mortgage industry has traditionally been focused on B2B constituents. So mortgage companies either make loans that investors want, or mortgage companies provide products and services primarily to realtors, title insurers, appraisers, and other folks that are part of the ecosystem. No mortgage company focuses on customer experience and building really a delightful onboarding process. And mortgages are hugely important, right? People don't buy houses for $700,000. People buy houses for $3,200 a month and $140,000 down. And so it's your most important financial decision. It's something that you don't do every 7 years. It's something that you're actually paying for every day. And the user experience is really terrible. So our focus is on how can we make this user experience delightful? How can we help people afford houses better? And how can we help them understand what they're buying in a much, much safer way?
And one of the hot topics here at Money 2020 is blockchain. Mm-hmm. Are you toying with the idea of using blockchain?
We think blockchain has a role to play in the mortgage industry, mm-hmm. and particularly in areas surrounding land and title.
Right.
And so, you know, U.S. residential real estate is a $29 trillion asset class. The land records are stored at 3,600 county courthouses across the country. To get at older land records, you have to send a person out there literally to pull a file, photocopy it, scan it, and then upload it. It's not OCR'd. So if we could take title and put it on a blockchain data set, we think we can probably save every consumer who's buying a house as much as $1,500 a year. And if that was true, that would be really, really amazing. So we think there's a lot of applications there. There's 3,600 counties, each with their own rules and regulations. So it's going to take some time.
Of course. And what about fraud? It's another hot topic. And what are you guys doing to protect your customers?
So fraud is really interesting in the mortgage space because people really want to own a house. And so sometimes in the past, particularly prior to the credit crisis, there were, you know, appraisals that were faulty. People would say that they were living on the water when they were actually facing the parking lot. Use. So people would say, I'm buying a second home and I'm going to live in it, but they were actually renting it out. So there's all these different cases where the consumers are either perpetrating the fraud or where different counterparties like an appraiser are perpetrating the fraud. So having a digital process means that we're able to find data disparities much, much faster than it was a traditional phone and paper based process. It means that we today at Better have the lowest error rate of any mortgage provider, of 6,000 mortgage providers in the country,
right.
And that is because we've got a digital process and therefore we're able to substantially lower fraud.
And what about AI? Is that something you're using or is that something you're thinking about using?
AI is a term that's misused a lot in financial services.
Right.
What we tend to think of it is that we've built a really wonderful rules engine, one that takes a consumer through a pathway and matches them with the best product at the best price at each step of the way. So you answer one more question and the next question tees up, which is going to enable you to get the mortgage faster and cheaper than you did before. And so that in the AI sense is called a supervised learning network. And so we have it in use in our process. The concept of real AI, sort of an unsupervised learning network where the machine just picks and asks you, like, what's your favorite color? And you say blue, and suddenly it gives you a mortgage. We are really far away from that.
Yeah. And finally, what are the top fintech trends that you think we're going to see in 2018?
I think 2018 will be a really great year for fintech because a lot of the promise of these processes is now starting to manifest them itself in form of a consumer value proposition that is remarkably better than what the traditional financial services industry, the banks, offer today.
Okay.
And we've now been able to separate the wheat from the chaff in financial service, mm-hmm. in fintechs, because there was a lot of noise. And so consumers are now starting to believe and use these services. It's very similar to, like, there was a turning point with the first dot-com era in 2001 to 2003, where the survivors of the bust, suddenly consumers really liked them. They started to have a little bit of pricing power, and then they just really started to take off and become pervasive. And so I think that's what you'll start to see in 2018.
Exciting. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.